it really started clicking at the right time. I mean, I was back against the wall. He was serving for the match. And hit a few really big forehands. And thankfully, it came around. You know, the first set and a half, I kind of felt a little tentative on the shot. Maybe wasn't going for enough. You know, he's got a really tricky game, too. Hits the ball really low and flat, so it's pretty tough. I like the ball up high so I can hit down on it, but it really keeps it below my knees, and I really have to use my legs to get under the ball. And so it took me a little while to get used to the pace of his shot and the way it was bouncing. So, you know, luckily I came up with some big forehands in that first set, in the second set tiebreaker, and at the end, and kind of got on the roll after that.
With some players, anger kind of hurts them, but with you, does it sometimes help you out?
Sometimes, you know, sometimes just to get it out. As long as I refocus for the next point, it's when it kind of builds up and it kind of goes point every each point. That's when it really hurts you. If I can, you know, everyone gets angry. If I can get angry and kind of snap back and, you know, bounce around and get ready for the next point, that's the only time when it'll help.
Looking ahead to 10 State Check, this is going to be a rematch of Knoxville Challenger and Champagne.
Yeah, he got me both times. He's a really good player. He's been playing incredible. You know, to end the year, he qualified for the U.S. Open, won a round, and took a title in Champagne. Same he's in Knoxville, so he's been playing really well, and it's going to be tough. You know, I'm 3 out of 5 sets. I've only played one of those matches in my life, and that was this year, so... you know, it'll be fun. We're good buddies, and you know, I think it'll be a good match.
You had a bunch of long points today at the end of the second set and early in the third. And after one of them, you said something like, "There's no way we can play tomorrow."
Yeah.
Do you think you can recover?
Well, luckily the third set went kind of fast. You know, once I got up a break, I think that helped a lot. If it would have gone, you know, 10-8 in the third set, then who knows? But luckily, kind of got on a roll and build up momentum and close it out pretty quick.
Do you think playing a lot of indoor tennis in college helped you at the spring and stuff and everything?
Yeah, definitely. Indoors is tricky. It stays very low and it's a lot quicker than outdoor. And college tennis, half the year is on indoor, so or even more. So it could definitely help getting all that time on indoor in college.
Obviously, your sights are set on Australia. If you happen not to win tomorrow, how would that affect your schedule?
Well, I'm still going down there. I'm actually going on the 23rd of December to go to Brisbane to the qualies. So I'll be down there regardless, whether I'm in the main draw or the qualifying draw. So as of now, I'm in the qualifying. If I win tomorrow, then I'll be for sure.
Yeah, in this kind of match with two really close sets, how do you think that your fitness difference now is kind of paying dividends for you?
Well, I've been working really hard, I can tell you that. This offseason has been brutal, really. I really haven't played that much tennis, to be honest, mainly focusing on the fitness aspect. So I feel pretty good out there. I thought I would be a little tired maybe coming to this tournament, but after today, really physical match, and I felt like I hung in there. So I think it's already paying off. Usually they say it takes a couple months to kick in, but I feel all right right now.
Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thanks.